Ladies and gentlemen, we come now to the evening's group, which of course is the Gundog group. Would you welcome into the ring, please, the judge for the Gundog group, Mrs. Anne Webster. Anne Webster is escorted into the ring by Mr. Eric Spenhas, Vice Chairman of the Cups Committee. Anne Webster has been involved in showing and breeding for 35 years and is now approved to award CCs in 17 breeds within the Gundog group and the group championship show level. Her overseas experience extends to most of Europe, South Africa, Australia, Argentina and Zimbabwe. And first in the ring, the Brittany. The English Chatter, the German Shorthair Pointer, the German Wirehair Pointer, the Gordon Setter, the Hungarian Vizsla, the Hungarian Wirehair Vizsla, the Irish Red and White Setter, the Irish Setter, the Italian Spinoni, the Large Monster Number, the Pointer, the Chesapeake Bay Retriever, the Curly Coated Retriever, the Flat Coated Retriever, the Golden Retriever, the Labrador Retriever, the Nova Scotia Black Tonic Retriever, the American Cocker Spaniel, the Clumber Spaniel, the Cocker Spaniel, the English Springer Spaniel, the Field Spaniel, the Irish Water Spaniel, the Sussex Spaniel, the Welsh Springer Spaniel, and finally, the Weimarana. I hand you over now to Graham Hill in the commentary box.
Thank you, David. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the group judging of the Gundogs, the only group on show here today, the third day of Press 2005. This is the fifth of our groups to be judged, out of the seven groups advanced to be seen in Press, or for that matter, any of the United Kingdom's championship shows. Every single one each of the attending Press has qualified. This year we have 21,432 dogs entered over the 4 days of Gruffs, with 4,909 of those being gun dogs. There are 178 different breeds entered overall. We see here the 27 breeds of gun dogs, which has been on show today. Exhibit we see here has been judged best of their particular breed, each being a breed associated with the job of HPR, or Hunt Point and Retrieve, associated with the gun. And following Mrs. Webster's initial appraisal of each breed, we'll be moving around the ring. Spaniels and Springers. the first of all that goes to be seen, the Brittany. The green was judged today by Mrs. M.J. Cutler. And there were 65 Brittany's present, from which she selected this male as her best of green, exhibit number 10549. The Brittany, known at one time as the Brittany Spaniel, finds its origins across the Channel in France. Is one of the hand-pointed retrieve breeds, and as such has already proved himself in the kennel club field trials. The Brittany. Though as a breed, the Brittany is fairly lightly built, is quite capable of carrying small game like hare and pheasant. It's a busy dog, is easy to train, has an affectionate, easygoing attitude to life. Dense fine coat is not difficult to keep clean. That's the Brittany. And next we see the English Setter. There were 222 dogs present. The breed had two judges, one for males and one for bitches. Mrs. L. Taylor did the males, and Mrs. L. Howarth the bitches. And they both selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 10807. The Setter is one of the most glamorous older number of breeds. A dog who not only has the ability to attract those who admire stylish working, but also those who want a dog capable of being a cheerful companion. The English Setter. This is a breed which combines elegance, quality, and stamina. A silky, easily green, groomed coat. Incidentally, the flapping on the coat is referred to as belter. Thus you get orange belter, lemon belter, or blue belter. That's the English Setter. Next to be seen is the German Shorthead Pointer. Mrs. M. Nixon was the breed judge, and from her entry of 251, she selected this bitch as best breed, exhibit number 10887. The German Shorthead Pointer, or GSP, was one of the first hand-point retrieve breeds to arrive in the United Kingdom from the continent. The German Shorthead Pointer has on several occasions won the coveted award, in the world of gun dogs, the Dual Championship, a dog able to beat all comers in the field and in the show ring. This is the German Shorthead Pointer. It's a green, good Spanish working fox. Something a little descent. The German Shorthead Pointer. Next we see the German Wirehead Pointer. Mrs. H. Parkinson was the breed judge. There were 76 German Wirehead Pointers present. And she selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 11077. This is another of the hand-point retrieve breeds from the continent introduced to the British scene more recently than his short-haired cousin. The German Wirehead Pointer is increasing in popularity with those who require a dog for the rough shoot. The thick, arch outer coat up to 1.5 inches in length protects them from the ravages of thorn and bramble. This is the German Wirehead Pointer. Bristly-coated gun dogs are always interested in Germans. In the late 1800s, there were several varieties. This wide variation led to the setting up of a separate organization, and so the German Wirehead Pointer came into existence. And today's Wirehead leads to the registration of all hunting dogs in Germany, the German Wirehead Pointer. And next we see the Golden Setter, one of our native London breeds. Mr. P.H. Woodland is the breed judge, judge entry 197. And this male is some of the best breed, exhibit number 11114. The Gordon Setter, or the Gordon, as he is affectionately known, hails from the estates of the Dukes of Gordon, located in his own homeland of Scotland. The Gordon has a long history of honesty and trainability, which endears him to those who appreciate the kindly, intelligent dog, capable of enjoying all the exercise which a household would give him. This is the Golden Setter. The Golden Setter comes in one colour back in the black tan. His appearance gives him the impression of being built to work steadily and without glamour all day and every day. And a dog that will do his job without fuss. That's the Golden Setter. And now we move to the Hungarian Wiesler. Mrs. P.A. Blaine was the breed judge, and from her entry of 196, this bitch was selected best of breed, exhibit number 11320. The Hungarian Friesland has its origins in the central plains of Hungary. It is thought that it reached there with the invaders from the Far East. The breed suffered as a result of wars in Europe, much of today's stock has been developed from dogs taken out of Hungary by the Hungarians. This is an intelligent dog with a very good memory, which makes him easy to train, and is responsive to intelligent handling. The Hungarian Friesland. Hungarian Friesland is a medium-sized, elegantly built, all-purpose gun dog, combining all the qualities of a good HBR gun dog. He has great stamina and is happy to work in all weathers. The Hungarian Friesland. Now we see the Hungarian Wirehead Friesland. The breed was judged today by Mrs. R. Pinkerton. There was an entry of 51 from which this bitch was selected. Best breed, exhibit number 11488. The Hungarian Wirehead Friesland is a truly handsome hunt, point and retrieve breed, the same glowing colours as the better known smooth country Friesland, which we saw earlier. The Wirehead Friesland has become more and more popular in Britain since 1991, when the breed came to the fore. This is the Hungarian Wirehead Friesland. He has the same stature as his cousin Friesland, but with a harsh jacket. He also has some of his bushy eyebrows which render his facial expression perhaps a trifle sterner. He has the same style of behaviour as the smooth-coated breed, and he is accepted as a good worker in the shooting world, the Hungarian Wirehead Friesland. And next we see the Irish Red Blight Setter, another of our vulnerable breeds. Mrs. Deanne Bowen was the breed judge, and from her entry of 101, she selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 11536. This breed derives from the same rootstock as the Irish Setter, and may have been his predecessor. Records provide several references to the breed being kept in the prominent kennels of the 17th and 18th centuries, one of which was owned by the Lord Rossmore of Monaghan. Sometimes, even today, the Red-White Setter is occasionally referred to as the Rossmore Setter. This is the Irish Red-White Setter. Described as athletic rather than racing. That's the Irish Red Point Setter. Next we see the Irish setup. The group having two judges today. Mr. J.S.F. Smith, judge of males. Mrs. A. Harvey Limitius. There's an overall entry of 425, from which the pitch was selected as to breed exhibit number 11699. The Irish setup is ranked among the most glamorous of all the gundogs. It is immensely popular with all manner of people. It is ideal as a central attraction for the glossy advertisement, with his rich chestnut coat gleaming as only that of a healthy athlete can. This breed gained popularity from about the late 1800s, with the breed club being formed in 1882. Here we see the Irish setter. This breed has an air of devilry care and is totally genuine with his friendly, affectionate nature, which makes him a good household dog, ready for all the fun and frolic of the family room and out. The Irish setter. Spinoni. Mr. C.B. Benson is the breed judge. There were 150 Spinonis present here at Grass. And this pitch was selected best to breed exhibit number 12120. The Italian Spinoni is an all-purpose gun dog, which has recently been brought back into Great Britain. It already has a fair degree of popularity with those who want hardy work in the field, or a faithful, patient companion. Another of the 100-point retrieve breeds from the continent. He is noted for his good scenting ability, soft mouth, and his especially successful as a brother, the Italian Spinoni. Though he is believed to have achieved championship status in Britain until 1994, it is a very old breed. Its origins are somewhat difficult to put together. This bulldog breed has a lot of blood and native hounds of Italy, mixed with that of French Griffons, the Italian Spinoni. And now we see the large Munster Hounder. Mrs. R. Weaver was the breed judge, and she selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 12196, from entry 106. This breed was first registered by the Kennel Club in 1971. Since then, he has proved himself both an effective worker and a family companion. The large Munsterlander is a biddable dog. His impression is he enjoys life and would like you to enjoy it too. This is the large Munsterlander. Large Munsterlander. Now we move on to the pointer. There's an entry of 284, which was judged by Mr. R.W. Twyman, and he selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 12290. The pointer is said to have originated in Spain, but has undoubtedly become a truly English breed over the last two or three centuries. During this time, he has been employed by shooting men in its traditional role of indicating the presence and position of sitting game. He combines a distinctive elegance with a sleek muscularity which enables him to cover great areas of ground at considerable speed. Here we see the pointer. Curb setting balance, speed over the ground, and steadiness on the point. A quality which was vital to the days of the slow loading flintlock weapons. And having found game, the pointer had to hold it until the hunter, and Hitika could catch up. That's the pointer. And now we move on to the Chesapeake Bay Retriever. This is J.M. R. Morris, who's the breed judge. He was in entry 50, and this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 12498. There is no doubt whatsoever about the origins of this breed. The tale goes about two puppies being rescued from a wrecked ship off the coast of the eastern seaboard of Maryland. They were reputed some two centuries ago to have been Newfoundland type. Discovered to lead water and sober crossed with the local retriever types, probably including the curly goat. The Chesapeake Bay Retriever. The result of the crossing of these two dogs was the ultimate professional waterproof dogs, the Chesapeake Bay Retriever. Basically a duck dog, he's his lively best in the water. The oilers thickness of the coat is so efficient that a thorough shake restores him to a slight moist feel in no time at all. That's the Chesapeake Bay Retriever. And next to the tree of retrievers we see the curly coated retriever. Judged by Mrs. D. Barney. There were 84 dogs making an entry of 101. And she made this male best of breed, exhibit number 12557. The unmistakable feature of this breed is his coat. His body, ears, and tails being covered with tight, crisp curls, whilst his face and muzzle are smooth hair. His coat is waterproof, and even after a swim and a quick shake, can be practically dry. The curly coated retriever was at its most popular as a shooting dog in the latter part of the 19th century. Here we see the curly coated retriever. The breed is around 200 years old and evolved from crosses of water spaniel and varieties of trees. The Somerset pointers. The coat seems to have come from crossing the poodles who were used to tie the curl of the coat. That is the curly coated retriever. Next we move to the flat coated retriever. There were two judges for this breed. Dogs were judged by Mr. D. Hutchinson and bitches by Mrs. S. J. Saville. An overall entry of 390 made by the 324 exhibits. This bitch was best of breed. Their exhibit number is 12654. This is a dog who loves human companionship. Definitely a dog not to be shut up on his own. This is when the Houdini-like qualities become apparent as he endeavors to reunite himself with friends and family. He's a tireless worker in the field and an excellent water dog and a natural swimmer. This is the flat coated retriever. One time known as the gamekeeper's dog, attracting attention and widely used in the late 1800s on the large estates of Great Britain. That is the flat-coated retriever. And now we move to the golden retriever. This is another breed that had two judges, one for males, Mrs. K.M. Sinister, and bitches, Mrs. Mr. K.A.W. Young. There's an overall entry of 618, and this male was made best of breed, exhibit number 13384. The Golden Retriever is one of the most popular dogs in the world. Bred, as its name suggests, to retrieve game in the field. The breed is adapted to many roles, but there is virtually nothing he cannot do, with the obvious exception of being a guard dog. His friendly temper makes him totally unsuitable for this job. This breed usually attracts the largest entries in our championship shows throughout Great Britain. This is the Golden Retriever. Young Katrina and his expertise as he used his gun dog, a drug dog, explosive detecting dog, a tracker, and an obedience competitor. All this is addition to simply being an energetic, fun-loving member of the family, the Golden Retriever. And now we move on to the Labrador Retriever. This received the largest loyal entries here at Crufts 2005, with an entry of 577, made by 519 exhibits. Dogs were judged by Mr. A.G. Taylor, bitches by Mr. R.A. Floyd. The male was made best of breed, exhibit number 13562. The Labrador is one of the best all-round dogs in the world. As with the Golden, he is not only used for retrieving game, but has also made his mark in the world of blind dogs, and as a citadel for drugs and explosive detection. This is the Labrador Retriever. I said, the Labrador Retriever got in the coast of Greenland, where fishing facilities are one of similar claims to being retrieved fish. The Labrador is not a very old breed, the breed club having been formed in 1960, and the Yellow Labrador Boar Club being founded in 1925. The Labrador Retriever. And we move on to the Nova Scotia Duck-Toed Retriever. This was another breed judged today by Mr. C.B. Bexler. There were 56 exhibits, an entry of 70. This male was made best of breed, exhibit number 13966. Canada is the country of origin of this breed, known affectionately as the Toller. He arrived in Britain as recently as 1998 and has made steady progress in popularity ever since. He has the canine equivalent of webbed feet, which enables him to swim very powerfully. He has intelligence, trainability, and is relatively easy to keep in good order because his coat is easy to groom. This is the Nova Scotia Duck-Toed Retriever. This retriever has a very strange method of work. His task is to use his waving white tip tail to lure waterfowl to within range of the guns and then retrieve them, especially from water. This is the Nova Scotia Duck-Toed Retriever. And now we see the first of the table gun dogs, the American Cocker Spaniel. The breed was judged today by Mr. M.J. Gadsby. There were 118 exhibits, making an entry of 139. This bitch was best to breed, exhibit number 14133. The American Cocker Spaniel, as his name implies, hails from America. It has been derived in the last century in America from Cocker Spaniels, ostensibly to retrieve quail. He has striking differences from his English forebear, most distinctive being the skull shape and profuse coat. The American Cocker Spaniel is a very cheerful fellow and makes a highly successful family dog. Here we see the American Cocker Spaniel. This is one of the Spaniel varieties that we've seen in the ring here tonight. On the small side of the region, 50 inches high, but does need careful grooming, the American Cocker Spaniel. Next we see the Clapper Spaniel. Mr. W. A. Kirkham was the pre-judge. There were 75 exhibits, making an entry of 85. This male was best to breed, exhibit number 148180. The club has been in the centre of coming the first place from France over 200 years ago. The breed was born to Britain by the Duke of Massa of Newcastle and bred at his family home in the Clumber Park of Nottinghamshire. Clumber Spaniel is a delightful breed which happily adapts to family life. He's one of our heavier spaniel types. This is the Clumber Spaniel. Just to look at the Clumber Spaniel, it's obvious he's a very heavy dog. He's the heaviest of the spaniel breeds. His pace of work is more leisurely than that of the other spaniels. He is blessed with the endurance and strength to get to places and do things that lighter spaniels can't. That's the Clumber Spaniel. Now we see at the table the Cocker Spaniel. The breed again had two judges. Mr. T. Gordon, judge of the males, and Mrs. J. Roberts, the bitches. With an overall entry of 422 made by 390 exhibits. This bitch was best of breed. Her number is 14229. The Cocker Spaniel, sometimes known as the Merry Cocker, is the most popular of the Spaniel family. An active, happy, intelligent, and affectionate dog. One that quickly adapts himself to his surroundings. The Cocker Spaniel was recognized as a second breed from the field and some Springer Spaniels soon after the formation of the Kennel Club in 1873. Here we see the Cocker Spaniel. He originated as the Cocker Spaniel, the writer's name from crushing woodcock. The breed has a great retrieving instinct, often employs his retrieving instinct around the house. He can be found with a toy or silver in his mouth, his tail wagging, waiting for praise. That's the Cocker Spaniel. Now we see the English Springer Spaniel. There was an entry of 236 made by 201 exhibits. This male was best of breed, exhibit number 14681. And the breed was judged by Mrs. Y. Billows. The English Springer Spaniel is the traditional dog for the rough shooter. A dog capable of working tirelessly all day, ready to enter water even on the coldest of days. The name Springer is derived from the use of the type of spaniel to startle the birds into the air so they spring upwards. This is the English Springer Spaniel. Now we see the Field Spaniel. Mr. C. R. Muirhead is the breed judge. There's an overall entry of 133 by 107 exhibits. His male was best of breed, and his exhibit number is 14803. Field Spaniel is a product of crossing the one-time Sussex Springer and the Cocker Spaniel in the late 19th century. It's interesting to note that very definite statement which the breed devotees have written into the breed standard to the effect that it's not suitable for the city. Not a popular breed by modern traits, he makes a good companion for the country dwellers.
This is the field spanner. Twice the green has nearly disappeared, firstly in the early 1900s, and secondly in the 1950s, when the green numbers were so small the green lost championship trip status. This was restored in 1969 following a determined effort by breeders to maintain the green. The field spaniel. And now we see the Irish water spaniel. There were 49 entries made by 41 exhibits here in Crufts, and Mrs. J.W. Johnson is the breed judge. This male was best of breed in exhibit number 14942. This is the tallest of the spaniels. The Irish water spaniel is a breed of great antiquity and is something of an enigma. Although in Britain he is shown as a spaniel, he works in the field trials as a retriever. He delights in water. He's an admirable enthusiastic retriever. A breed of great intelligence, which is thought to be derived from the poodle, which has obviously played a significant part in his ancestry. This is the Irish water spaniel. The Irish water spaniel attracted great attention when exhibited in Birmingham in 1862. An affectionate, hard-working breed with a distinct sense of humour. It makes a lovable family dog reveling in all the exercises that is on offer. The Irish water spaniel. Now we see the Sussex Spaniel. Miss S.A. Leslie was the breed judge. From her entry of 66, she selected this male as best of breed. Exhibit number 15002. The Sussex Spaniel is an old breed of great substance and is unusual amongst men dogs, but he tends to be somewhat vocal when working. The Sussex Spaniel is wider in the head than many Spaniel breeds and has a rather wrinkled brow, which gives him a frowning expression. This is the Sussex Spaniel. The breed is a country dog and is capable of being a family dog in a country household. Led doing his work, crashing his way through thick cover of the field. The Sussex Spaniel. And now we see the Welsh Oswego Spaniel. This is M.P. Gately, who's the breed judge, from entry 203, made by 180 exhibits. She selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 15059. The Welsh Spring Spaniel is somewhat smaller and finer in head than its English cousin. It is equally kindly and temperate. Any suggestions of the Welsh Springer as it originated from the English Springer would not be supported by me, especially as a Welshman. The Welsh Springer was recognised as a breed in its own right by the Elder in 1902. This is the Welsh Springer Spaniel. The breed spaniel is a super working good bird from its homeland in Wales, made this breed popular throughout Britain and the world. Its popularity has increased steadily, and he has become a favourite household dog in much the same way as other spaniels. The Welsh Springer Spaniel. And the final breed to be seen in the Gun Dog Group is the Vibrama. Mr. C.M. Brown was the breed judge. There were 253 present, making an entry of 286. And this bitch was made best of breed, exhibit number 15291. The Weimaraner is another of the multi-purpose hunter-point retrieve dogs coming to Britain from the continent. The breed's striking feature is grey coloration and his light eyes. The Weimaraner has increased popularity with the shooting fraternity because of his all-round efficiency in carrying out his duties as a gun dog. This breed hails from Germany, where it takes its name from the German quarter Weimar, where it found much favour. There is even a background painting of the dog of the Weimaraner type, dated in the early 1600s. The Weimaraner. Examination of each exhibit is completed. Mrs. Webster will take another short look at each breed exhibit before selecting a shortlist. Starting with the first breed, the Grizzly. We'll move steadily right through the group, just recounting her thoughts. It is usual for a shortlist debate to be made for further consideration by the judge, and obviously the number to be pulled out is at the judge's discretion. Maybe more than 8, maybe less. Said at the start of the judging, there are 27 breeds of gun dogs here in the ring. All the finest from an overall entry of 4,909 gun dogs. The winner of this group made the fifth place. The fifth finest in all our group winners. Is in third place and our judging on Sunday evening at Aston Show. Right, examination completed, I think. First of our breeds to be shortlisted, the English Setter. The Hungarian Beetle, the German Shorthead Pointer, the Italian Spadoni, the Curly Coated Retriever, the Golden Retriever, the American Cocker Spaniel, the English Springer Spaniel and the Irish Springer Spaniel. The Welsh Springer Spaniel and the Weimaraner. Our judge goes to shake the hands of those within the ring. Can I ask you to give them a warm applause? Congratulations on your achievement to the best in the world.
To recap, winner of the Denmark Group,
Crafts 2005, the English setter. Exhibit number 10807. Group 2, the English Springer Spaniel. Exhibit number 14681. Group 3, the Vibram 15291. Group 4, the Italian Spaghetti 12120. The winner now will be presented with the 7 gold vase. The presenter will be led in by Mr. Eric Spenders, who is Lord Fairhaven. So please, warm applause for our winner of the Glenrock Crafts 2005, the English setter. To the English Springer Spaniel, exhibit number 14681. And group 3, the Vibram, exhibit number 15291. And group 4, the Italian Spaghetti, 12120. Followed by our winners. Another opportunity for you to show your appreciation. Congratulations on winning the group. Your first 2005. As our winners go to the photographic area, I wish you all a safe journey home. One more.